So we are now in week two of Test Realm, and we've already gotten an update this Monday morning for the new spell audit changes and some other changes that have been put into this Test Realm. One of them is the Beast Moon Mayhem has been activated, so that is going. I know there's some changes there. I'm not going to check it out, but just wanted to mention that. But the other changes that I want to look at in this video are going to be the continuation of the spell audit. So Ratbeard posted on the forums this list of all these spells that they have already changed in Test Realm or they're planning on changing. And I want to keep going through that list because we've already looked at the first few changes with the blades and traps and everything. So if you missed that video, then go check that out before this one. But now we've made it to 1 and 2 pip spells. And life was one of the schools that they changed the most spells. So we'll start with that. And then balance was another school that they changed a lot of spells on. Every school has some changes, but life has a decent amount of them because life has a lot of interesting utility cards. Guidance was one of the spells that I mentioned that I thought they would change because they've already been changing the other accuracy blades. And Guidance puts up a blade on everyone on your team for 1 pip. It used to be 10% and they upped it to 20 because that kind of goes in line with the other changes that they've made. They changed the precision card for balance to be 25%. And they also changed Lightning Strike for Storm to be 25, so those are both 25. And they decided that Guidance should be 20 because it's put on everyone. So that is one of the changes. The other one is going to be Triage. Triage is now 1 pip instead of 0. And it still does the same thing, removes the overtime. Triage is interesting because you can go ahead and pick a target to remove the overtime. And yes, it's going from 0 pips to 1, so that is a nerf on Triage, and this will probably affect PvP a lot more than it affects PvE. But yeah, going from 0 to 1, this also changes the TC, so other schools can use Triage if they have the Triage TC, and now they're going to have to spend 1 pip in order to do that. Could be a power pip too if you don't have any regular pips. You might have to use a power pip in order to do this unless you have the pip conversion, but yeah, that is how that works, with Triage being 1. And they've also changed the Mass Prism cards. So this is a change for every single school, and Prisms are going from 2 pips to 1. So same kind of pip conversion thing applies. If you have a power pip and you have pip conversion, then you might get a pip back. The same thing applies to all the other Mass Prisms. So on my life, I have Mass Storm Prism trained because, you know, I always have a Storm Hitter, and casting Mass Storm Prism for them is super useful. Now I only have to use 1 pip instead of 2, which actually is a big deal, because having to use 1 pip, like 1 power pip instead of 2 power pips to cast this will save supports a lot of the pips that they have to cast these kind of things. So this is a good change and definitely makes it easier to cast Prisms. Moving on, Brilliant Light is another one that they changed for life. And it used to be 2 pips gives the 30% to all of your teammates, and now they're down to 1 for that, so it makes sense. I always wonder why that one was 2 pips. So kind of a minor change there, because I feel like 2 pips wasn't too bad for this, but yeah. It kind of just goes in line with the other spells, being 1 pip, putting that 30 heal blade on everyone. And then, is there any other ones here? Oh yeah, this is a big one. Mass Triage is another one they changed. And Mass Triage used to be 3 pips. Which definitely was too expensive for this. It will remove 1 overtime from everyone on your team, so that's super good. 3 pips just made it really awkward, even for a life wizard, because you have to use, like, if you have an odd number of pips, it just makes spells harder to use. And 3 pips was one that was very difficult to use for this type of spell. Even if I would go into fights knowing that Mass Triage could be a good spell to use, I wouldn't use it because it's a waste of pips. 3 pips for this was pretty bad. I feel like 2 makes it way more usable. Maybe I'll put this in and actually be able to like use this as a heal on my teammates by removing overtimes if you know that the enemies are going to cast something. So this is a good spell. I'm glad they changed this. As a life wizard, I'll probably use this more now that it's actually usable. So yeah, I like this one a lot. It's a good change. All right, now we're just gonna jump around on my other characters and check out the other changes. There's not really too many on other schools, at least schools that I have, but they did change Disarm for Storm to only be 0 pips instead of 1. So that is a big change. It doesn't really affect PvE as much as it would PvP, but just want to make you guys aware of this. Disarm is now zero, so that is one of the new changes. And then for Storm, the only other change is going to be with Mass Storm Prism, of course. That's now one pip. Okay, jumping on my fire here, we'll check out the changes to fire. So fire has Steel Charm, which has been updated, basically buffed, to be 100%. These utility spells, you can tell they just want them to be all 100% accuracy. They updated weakness to be 100%, and now Steel Charm. This is a big deal because back in the day when we used the Steel Charm strat on Shane Von Shane, I kind of miss that strat. Now Shane is so easy, but there was a chance that the strat failed because you could fizzle Steel Charm. And now they're removing that chance. It's 100% because basically a utility card. You already are spending one pip on this anyway to, you know, steal the enemy's charm. So that is an update for fire right there. And then, of course, Mass Fire Prism is, reduced to one pip. They didn't change Smokescreen. And they didn't mess with Backdraft or anything. They didn't mess with Detonate. So yeah, all these spells are the exact same except Fuel. Fuel has been updated to the universal 30% for every trap, which is basically what Kingzell is trying to do here. Basically say all these base traps are going to be 30%. Fuel is going to be 30% for three, but you have to spend two pips on it. So kind of just making it all in line with how other traps are set up. And then no changes to any of these spells. All right, so Death only has one change, and that change is going to be Empower has been reduced from take 300 damage to take 250, though they didn't change it to moon damage. They made it death damage. I guess they didn't want to make it as powerful as these other ones, like Sacrifice, where they made it 250 moon damage. They could still change it, I don't know, but they are leaving it as death damage. So if you want to get three extra pips and you're soloing as a death, you got to make sure that you don't have any death blades because it will take those and you won't have that anymore. But you will have three pips. You just won't have any blades. So keep that in mind with Empower. It's just less damage taken. So I'm back in my life just because I don't have any of the remaining schools to show you guys. So I'm just going to have to put the spells on the screen. But we'll start with Ice here. So Ice had two spells that have been changed. One of them is Steel Ward, which has been reduced from two pips to one. So you can now use Steel Ward for one pip. And that just makes it easier to go ahead and actually use this spell as an Ice Wizard and not use a full power pip. If you have pip conversion, then you might get a pip back. So that is one of the changes for Ice. The other one, this is a big one. The other one is Legion Shield. They have decided to buff Legion Shield. It's still one pip, but it's now a 45% shield. This is actually crazy. Like, out of all the buffs, this is probably the craziest one. I do like the Mass Prism one, but I feel like this Legion Shield change is going to affect things the most. So now Legion Shield is almost a Tower Shield, but on everyone for one pip. That is one of those that I could understand if they upped it to two pips. But yeah, it's one pip, Legion Shield, 45% shield on everyone. And that's pretty crazy. I was thinking about this and I'm like, there are pets with Maycast Legion Shield. And I'm wondering if those are going to also use this card. So that is a big change. We'll see if they go through with that one. But yeah, that was kind of crazy to me to see that. But that is it for Ice. So Ice gets those two changes. So the last school we need to look at is going to be Balance. And I can show some of these because I have some Balance school spells as a support. You should have these. We have Elemental Trap, which of course has been updated to 30%, just like the other schools. What's weird is Spirit Trap is still 25. I'm going to look through Ratbeard's post here. I feel like this should be up to date. Yeah, it should be. Okay. So I was like, wait, why are they discriminating against the Spirit Trap here and, you know, not Elemental Trap? But I think this is just them only updating Elemental Trap right now, and they're planning on doing this because it is in Ratbeard's notes for getting an update. So yeah, Spirit Trap and Elemental Trap, just pretend it says 30. These are both going to be 30%. The blades are the same. I don't expect them to change these because This is probably what they based the 35% off of, is these. They already knew that these were 35, so they just decided, what if we make all the blades 35? Except balance. Balance is 25. Sorry, balance. But yeah, that is kind of the base for what they're going off of on these. They didn't base the traps off of these traps, though, because they decided to up it to 30. Another balance spell that they changed is the Elemental Spear and Spirit Spear. Both of those are being upgraded to plus 20%, and that'll be plus 20% pierce for each of those blades. So those are, that's a huge difference, because it used to be plus 6%, and that's being up to plus 20% pierce for each blade. So big change there. Helping Hands got a little readjustment again. So there is the updated Helping Hands. They also updated Supernova. Still two pips, 60%, which 60% accuracy, that feels really low, but that's what it is. And it will do 405 damage. So a nerf on that one from 535 to 405 to the target, destroy their aura. So those are all the spells that they changed so far in the spell audit. If there's anything else, I will continue to do videos on them looking at the changes. If they're major, if it's just like a couple spells, I probably won't cover it until they do more. But yeah, Ratbeard says in the post that there are more changes to come. We will see. But so far, they're focusing on all of these utility spells for each school. And I like a lot of the changes. I know people have been upset. Trust me, I've seen the comments. I know people are upset about the blade changes because it is a nerf to a lot of schools. And I understand that. They're just trying to standardize it. But yeah, I've seen people's comments. I don't know if they're going to do anything about this, but it seems like they want the blades to all be 35%. And I feel like the blades are the thing that people complain about the most. But that is going to do it for this video. So let me know your guys' comments on all of this, on everything that changed in the recent patch. And I'll be doing more test room videos as necessary. We'll see if things change and if I decide that I should cover it, I'll do that. Check out the test room playlist. Leave a like if you guys have enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you all next time.